So yeah, you were talking about HBCU students, and what do you think is important about them coming to travel here, visit, learning in China?
Yeah, the interesting thing about HBCU students that don't travel abroad or have any intentions, I don't think have any intentions or have a understand what how important it is to travel abroad to work and to study, is to learn how the global economy actually working and how they can actually understand their role that they can have, they can learn also the influence that they can have on others to help the economic conditions, and people may find this kind of bold, but help the economic conditions of black folks in America. Because right now you have, when the president talks about the TPP and trade pacts and all that right there, and some people get blown up, oh, it's going to lose jobs and so forth and so on. And it's not that it's going to lose jobs, it's that most people don't know how to go out and do the business so they can create the job. And if you don't control the means of production, you either way you're going to start working for somebody or you're going to create the ways of working. And that way you have to decide how are you going to fit into this global marketplace. And HBCU students, I believe, that they really don't understand that aspect. They graduate with good grades, but their first intentions may be to go work for somebody else, which is my opinion. It's an okay thought, but being that I've been down that road before, I prefer that you go out and try to work for yourself. At least try to go out and see what is out there in the marketplace that you could actually benefit you in the long run, that you could teach others and show them how it could benefit them. But and that's where they drop off the curve at. There's like a big trend here now in China. There's three main focal areas right now. It's the up and coming middle class, and it's the new generation of young people born in the 80s and born in the 90s, and also e-commerce. Those are the three driving forces going to be for the next 20 or 30 years in China. And most people don't recognize that those things are the driving forces or how to go about to penetrate those areas.
Okay. All right. Let's stop.